Hello viewers, welcome back to the course on scientific computing using MATLAB. So today we'll continue with our lecture 20. So in the last lecture we have just started with the Gauss elimination method for the direct method. So this is we are writing Gauss elimination method. So in this case, what we are going to do, I am have a system A x equal to B, that is n cross n, and then I will write down my augmented matrix A. So this is my augmented matrix. And we will convert this matrix into a upper triangle matrix, and then using back substitution we will get the solution, we will solve the system. So let us start with this Gauss elimination method. So for example, so let us take 3x3 system. So I will just define a 3x3 system A11 x1 plus a12 x2 plus a13 x3 is equal to b1 a21 x1 a22 x2 plus a23 x3 is equal to b2 a31 x1 plus a32 x2 plus a33 x3 is equal to b3. So this is my system A x is equal to B, and I am taking 3x3 matrix. Now the, so this is my a system of equation. Now what I want to do, I want to reduce this one into the upper triangular matrix. So I want to make this element 0. So this element and this element, this one I want to make 0, because only then you will be able to get the upper triangular matrix. So let us start with this one. So step 1, so in the step 1 we define a, take a multiplier, so I call it M 21. So what is the M21? What I will do is that I will divide this row by A11. So I will get the 1 only. And to remove this value of A21, so now what I do, so before that I just write the matrix A11, A12, A13. And then B1 A21 A22 A23 A31 A32 A33, and this is my B2 and this is my B3. So this is my augmented matrix A. Okay, so now whatever I am going to do, I am going to do with this augmented matrix. Generally we represent it by tilde. Now I take a multipliers A21. So to multiply, what I will do, I will divide this first row by A11 and multiply by A21 with a negative sign, and then I will add to this one, so this will make it 0. So I will take a multiplier A21 and then I will write minus A21 by A11. So this is the multiplier I am going to find out. Now I'll write down multiply the first row, that is R1, with M21 and add to the second row, to the row, to the second row, because I want to make this element 0. So, that is my condition. So, what I do? I will multiply the first row with m 2 1 and add to the second row. So, I can write as a m 2 1 to r 1 adding to r 2, and the effect goes to the r 2. So, this will I am going to do the first one. The second one is same. Now, my next, after doing this, I want to make this element also 0. So, how to make this one? The same one. Take a multiplier m31, because I want to make the this element 0. So, I will call it m31. So, it is same as a31 divided by a1. So, dividing the first row by a11 and multiply it by minus of a31, and then I will call it m31 multiply by r1 adding to r3, and the effect go to r3. So, after these two steps, my system will reduce to, so after above steps, so step number 1, which consists of two more steps, the sub steps. So, after these steps, I will get the system becomes, so I will get the system a11 x1 plus a12 x2 plus a13 x3 is equal to b1, because there is no change in the first row. Okay. The next thing is that I will get here a22 x2. So, I will call it as 2 plus a23 x3 is equal to b2. Okay. So, I will get this one. Then I will get here a32 x2 plus a33 x3 is equal to b32. So, this 2 is writing here. So, that is the after step 1. Or after iteration 1 or after step 1. So, I am getting the value of here. So, what is the value of a22? So, my a22 will be, so I am multiplying this one by m21. So, I will write down is it. So, this is a12 multiply by m21 and adding to a22. So, that is the we are getting. So, from here I can write, if you see from here, it will be equal to a22 minus of a11 into a12. So, that is the value of the this coefficient. Similarly, I can define my a23. So, this will be again same as a23 plus m21 a13. So, that will getting the new value. Similarly, a32 will be what? So, it will be same as multiplying and adding. So, it will be a32 plus m31 a12. Okay. And then a233 will be a33 plus m31 a13. So, this will give me, and then from here I can write my b2 and b3 also. So, after doing this one, my b2, so b2 will be what? b1 multiply by m 21. So, I am multiplying this one by m 21 and adding to b 2. B 3 multiplying b 1 by m 31 plus b 3. So, that is my new values and I am getting my system in this way. Now, if you see from here, now I have to deal with this system, 2 by 2 system. So, I have to remove this value to make it the upper triangular. So, now I do the step 2. So, in the step 2, I am dealing with this system. So, this system I can call it double star. So, I will apply the same way. So, in this case, what I will do is now I will define my new multiplier. So, I will define multiplier m 32 because I want to make this element 0. So, that will be what minus a 32 divided by a 22 and whatever we are getting at the this step. So, I will do the process here. So, now I will write down multiply R 2 with M 32 adding to R 3 and effect is going to R 3. So, after doing this one, I will get my system because here only I have to deal with only one element, then I will get the system. So, this is I will get A 11 x 1 plus A 12 x 2 and A 13 x 3 is equal to B 1. Then I will get a 22 x 2 plus a 23 x 3 is equal to b 22 and then I will get here a 33 3 x 3 and that is equal to b 3 3. So, this is the system we are getting. Now, from here we can write that my a 33 and 3 will be what? So, it will be a 23 multiply by m 32 and adding to a 33 at the second step. So, that will be my a 33 and my b 3 will be b 2 multiply by 32 and adding to b 3 at the step 2. So, this is the value we are getting and after getting after this one. So, this system now we are getting the equivalent system. So, this is I am writing here. So, equivalent system can be written as, so now this equivalent system can be written as a 11, a 12, a 13, a 22, a 23, a 33 and all other elements are 0 and that is equal to x 1, x 2, x 3 and this is b 1, b 2 and b 3. Now, so after getting this value, now using back substitution, we are getting x 3 will be b 3 3. From here, my x 2 will be b 2 minus a 2 3 x 3 divided by a 2 2. Okay. So, because this will be x 2 a 2 2 plus a 2 3 x 3 is equal to b 2, and my x 1 will be b 1 minus a 1 2 x 2 minus a 1 3 x 3 divided by a 1 1. So, if you from here you can see that it is provided a is not equal to 0, it is provided a 1 is not equal to 0. So, by the back substitution now we are able to solve my system. So, this is called the Gauss elimination method, but the only if you see that the so we have done this one for 3 by 3 matrix. So, the same way we can go for n by n matrix, and so from here I can write down Gauss elimination method is involved with n minus with n minus 1 steps for n cross n matrix, because in the previous one we have a 3 by 3 cross matrix. So, in within 2 steps we are able to solve this one. So, if I have a n cross n matrix using the n minus 1 steps, we are able to convert the matrix into the upper triangle and then we can solve the system. So, this Gauss elimination involves n minus 1 steps. Now, the problem comes here. So, where is the problem? Where is the problem? So, the problem is that what will happen if a 1 1 is 0 or very small. So, if it is 0 then we cannot proceed, or if it is very very small then we already know that we lose significant digit. In the previous lecture we have seen that if we are dividing by with a very small number then we lose significant digit. So, in that case we also this is not permissible. So, what will happen if I have a 1 1 or a 2 2 or a 3 3 are very small. So, in that case my Gauss elimination method will not work and it will not give you the exact solution. So, to get rid of this problem, what we do? We take a pivoting partial pivoting. So, in the previous lectures in the previous slide, so these elements we call it this element, maybe this element and this elements, they are called pivot. Pivot means it is a very important elements. So, now we have to deal with this one that how we can remove this difficulty when we have this elements at the diagonals are very small in number. So, that can be done with the help of partial pivoting. So, what is the partial pivoting? So, in the partial pivoting what we do is that suppose we have a equation system. So, let I have a my system, I have a n cross n system. A 2 1 a n 1 a 2 2 a 2 n a n n. So, what do we do is that? So, we will do step 1. So, in the step 1 what do we do? So, then the step one in the elimination, the first column is searched for the largest element. In magnitude. Okay, so we have to deal with the magnitude, it may be a negative also, and brought as the first pivot in magnitude by interchanging the first and by interchanging the rows. Rows means whatever the row has the largest element with the first row. So, we can interchange that one and the same procedure, and this is done with all the subsequent steps. So, I can call it not the step one. So, this is the procedure basically. So, the first column is searched for the largest element in magnitude and brought to the first pivot in the magnitude by interchanging the row, and this is done with all the subsequent steps. So, in this case what will happen, like suppose I have a system like this one, somebody gives me the system, it is 0, 1, 2 and 1, 5 and then it is maybe minus 3, 2, 0, 1, okay. And somebody asks me to solve this system. X1, X2, X3 is equal to maybe 1, 2, minus 1. So, what I will do that, if I want to apply the Gauss elimination, then this element is 0. So, what I do? I will find out, the first step is that I will find out the largest value in magnitude. So, maybe in magnitude the largest value is this one, because if I take the modulus value of minus 5, that is a 5. So, what I do in this case? I will do the R13. So, after doing the R13, what I will get? I will get the value minus 5, 0, 1, 1 minus 3, 2, 0, 1, 2, and x1, x2, x3 will not change, because I am just transferring, interchanging the equations. So, it will be minus 1, 2, 1. I am taking this equation there. And now, it is the largest element in magnitude here. Now, I can apply my Gauss elimination method, and based on this Gauss elimination method, because it is already 0, so then it is useful for us. So, in this case I will find the upper triangular matrix and will be able to solve using Gauss elimination. So, this is called the partial power weighting. So, generally we go always go for partial power weighting, but there is another term also, complete power weighting. So, we hardly go for this complete power weighting. So, in this case what we will do? We find the largest element in magnitude in the whole matrix. So, my matrix is n cross n. So, we will find the largest element in magnitude in the whole matrix and brought as a first pivot. first pivot. So in this case what is happening? So first pivot by interchanging rows and columns also. So in this case the variable may be shifting. So that is called the complete pivoting. So the problem with that, in this case we can interchange the row, so row is okay, but when we interchange the column then the position of the variable will change. So then it will make the life much complicated. So we generally don't go for complete pivoting, we always go for the partial pivoting. Now there are some other type of matrices are there which are very useful when we are dealing with the Gauss elimination method, and we call it diagonal dominant matrices. So this is called the diagonal dominant matrices. For example, I have a matrix A. So a matrix is, so I am talking about the real matrix, okay, is called diagonal dominant, is called diagonal dominant matrix if my Aii modulus value is greater than or equal to summation of Aij when j is not equal to I, and this is true for I 1 2 to n. It means that the diagonal elements, the magnitude of the diagonal element is always greater than or equal to the summation of the magnitude of the other elements. So if this is true, then we call it the diagonal dominant matrix. If Aii is strictly greater than this one, then it is called strictly diagonal dominant. Okay. So for example, I take a matrix A is like this one, I get a minus 5, 1, 2, 3, minus 4, 0, 1, 2 and maybe 4. So in this case what is happening? Now if I take the diagonal element 5, so this is always greater than 1 plus 2, the other element I am taking. The next is minus 4, so this is greater than 3 plus 0. The next last is 4 is greater than 1 plus 2. So this is true, then I will say that this is strictly diagonal dominant matrix. Or maybe I can take another example, like 5, 2, 3 and maybe 4, 6, 2 and 2, 2, 3, minus 3, suppose I am taking, minus 2, this I am taking. So in the first one, 5, so this element, because we always go for these pivots, the diagonal elements. So in this case what is happening, this 5 is equal to minus I, the first row. Second is minus 6 is 4 plus 2. Then the last one is minus 3 is less than 2 plus 2. So, this here it is not satisfying this condition. So, not diagonally dominant. So, from here I can make a statement that if A n cross n is diagonal dominant, matrix, if it is a diagonal dominant matrix, then no partial weighting is needed for Gauss elimination. So, in that case, there is no need of doing the partial weighting for applying the Gauss elimination method. So, this is all about in this lecture. So, I hope you have understood that how we can apply the Gauss elimination method and what is the partial weighting, what is the diagonal dominance matrix. So, in the next lecture, we will continue with this one. So, thanks for viewing. Thanks very much.